Hello and welcome to my channel. Have you ever been confused about electrical interlocks or struggled to design circuits like forward and reverse power circuits, control circuits, or even star delta configurations? Don't worry, I've got you covered. In this video, I'll break down the concept of electrical interlocks, explain their role in ensuring safe and efficient operation, and show you how to apply them in real-world circuits. By the end, you'll have the confidence to master these concepts and design circuits like a professional engineer, technician, or student. Let's get started without wasting your time. And hey, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel as a token of appreciation. It really motivates me to bring you more valuable content. Let's move to the electrical interlock. Let's talk about electrical interlocks. Think of an interlock as a rule that says something can only happen if certain conditions are met. If those conditions are not met, the system will not work. This helps keep things safe and make sure everything works properly. I'm not going into the circuit just yet, but let me first give you some real-life examples that will help you understand electrical interlocks. Let's say water pump control. Imagine you have a water pump in your home. The pump will only turn on if the water tank is low or it's not full. And once the water tank gets full, the pump will automatically turn off. This is because of the interlock. It stops the pump from running when it's not needed. You may experience forward and reverse motor control. Picture a motor that can run forward or in reverse. If the motor is already running forward, you can't press the button to run it in reverse until it stops running forward. This is another example of an interlock. It makes sure that both actions don't happen at the same time. The most common example is the microwave oven, which you use in daily life. Think about using a microwave. The microwave will only start cooking if the door is completely closed. If the door is open, it won't start. This is an interlock to keep us safe. You also experience the automatic car ignition. In a car, you can't start the engine unless the gear is in neutral or park. This is another interlock to prevent accidents and ensure the car doesn't move when starting. In all of these examples, the interlock is there to make sure things happen in the right order and keep everything safe and working properly. Why do we need interlocks in electrical systems? Let's break it down. Safety first. Interlocks are designed to keep you safe. For example, they stop motors from running if there's a problem, like when the motor is overloaded, preventing accidents or damage. Protecting equipment. Interlocks also protect your expensive machinery. They make sure that equipment doesn't get damaged, like stopping a motor from running in reverse when it's already moving forward, saving it from mechanical failure. Efficiency and smooth operation. With interlocks in place, everything works smoothly. They ensure that conflicting operations don't happen at the same time, so everything runs the way it should, without issues. So interlocks are not just about preventing accidents. They keep your systems working safely, efficiently, and reliably. Here's a question for you to think about. Imagine that K1, K2, and K3 contactors are all energized and running. Now what happens if I press STPB1, the stop push button? Think carefully. What would the system do if all these contactors are running and you hit the stop button? How does the interlock system respond to this situation? If you understand how interlocks work in this scenario, go ahead and drop your answer in the comments below. Let's see if you can figure it out. I'll be waiting to read your thoughts. Let's break this circuit down in a simple way so you can easily understand how interlocks work in this circuit. I have created some scenarios to provide more clarity for all the engineers, technicians, and my students. Scenario 1. If I want to start K2 by pressing Start PB2, will it start? No, it's not. Why? Because K1 must be running first. There's an interlock, a normally open contact of K1, that prevents K2 from activating until K1 is energized. Scenario 2. If I want to start K3 by pressing Start PB3, will it start? Again, no, it's not. That's because both K1 and K2 must already be running. Interlocks in K3's circuit make sure it won't activate out of sequence. Scenario 3. Now, if I press Start PB1, does K1 start? Yes, it does. This button directly energizes K1, provided there's no overload or stop condition. Scenario 4. What if I press Start PB2 after K1 is running? Will K2 start? Yes, it will. Why? because now K1's interlock in K2's circuit has closed, allowing K2 to activate. Scenario 5. If I press start PB3 after K2 is running, will K3 start? Yes, that's because the interlock from K2 has now cleared the way for K3 to energize. Scenario 6. What happens if I press stop PB2 while K1, K2, and K3 are running? K2 and K3 stop. The stop button breaks K2's circuit, de-energizing it, and it also stops K3 as the K2 interlock is used there, but K1 remains unaffected. Scenario 7. What if I press stop PB1 while both K1 and K2 are running? In this case, K1 stops and K2 also stops. That's because stopping K1 opens its interlock in K2's circuit, cutting power to both. Scenario 8. If K3's overload trips, does it affect K1 and K2? Nope. No, only K3 stops. Overload relays are independent for each contactor, so the other circuits continue running without issue. By now, you should see how interlocks act as safety guards, ensuring everything operates in the correct order. If this explanation helped, let me know your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. After gaining clarity on electrical interlocks, let's dive into understanding how to operate a star delta starter with forward and reverse functionality. This setup uses 4 push buttons: start, stop, forward, and reverse. I'll guide you step by step through the power circuit and control circuit, highlighting how interlocks play a critical role in ensuring safe, efficient, and effective operation. By the end, you'll have a clear understanding of how these systems work together seamlessly. So let's get started. The star delta starter is a widely used system in industries, primarily because of its ability to reduce starting current, which helps prevent high inrush currents that could otherwise damage the motor. It also provides directional control, enabling motors to operate in forward or reverse directions depending on application requirements. Additionally, the smooth transition from star to delta mode ensures efficient and safe operation, especially for heavy machinery, making it an essential component in industrial motor control systems. Now, let's talk about the core components. Q1 power breaker. It's the 3-phase power provider for the motor. Overload relay. Think of this as your safety shield. It protects the motor from overheating or excessive current by tripping when things go wrong. Q2 control breaker. This keeps the low voltage control circuit safe, isolating it from the high power circuit. With that in mind, let's break this system down into 2 essential circuits. The main goal in the star delta motor configuration is to initially run the motor in star configuration, which limits the starting current. After a few seconds, a timer shifts the motor to delta configuration, enabling it to operate at full speed and deliver its rated power. I aim to explain the reverse forward star delta control circuit operation through specific scenarios to ensure 100% clarity and understanding of its functionality. My goal for this video isn't just to gain views, but to provide you with complete clarity. Case 1. You need to run the motor in forward direction with star configuration and then delta configuration. When you press the start push button, followed by the forward push button, what happens? K1, forward contactor, K3, main contactor, and K5, star contactor engage. The motor starts running in the forward direction using the star configuration. After 5 seconds, the timer deactivates K5, star contactor, and energizes K4, delta contactor, through the interlock. Now the motor continues to run in the forward direction in full delta mode. Look at the control circuit. It has an interlock that ensures K3 main contactor and K5 star contactor engage only when K1, forward, contactor is energized. If the motor direction is not selected, the motor will not start, ensuring proper functionality and safety. Now, case 2. You need to run the motor in reverse direction with star configuration and then delta configuration. When you press the start push button followed by the reverse push button, what happens? K2 reverse contactor, K3 main contactor, and K5 star contactor engage. The motor starts running in the reverse direction using the star configuration. After 5 seconds, the timer deactivates K5 star contactor and energizes K4 delta contactor through the interlock. Now, the motor continues to run in the reverse direction in full delta mode. Look at the control circuit. It has an interlock that ensures K3 main contactor and K5 star contactor engage only when K2 reverse contactor is energized. If the motor direction is not selected, the motor will not start, ensuring proper functionality and safety. You also see that K3 main contactor will not energize until K5 star contactor engages. This is also an interlock or condition. The purpose is to engage both the K3 main contactor and K5 star contactor together. To reverse the motor's rotation, we have to swap two phases, such as the red and blue phases, which alters the direction of the rotating magnetic field and changes the motor's direction. So, don't get confused about how the motor will start in reverse direction with K2 reverse contact. It is because when you swap any two phases, the motor direction changes as the direction of the rotating magnetic field changes. I advise, if you are a new technician, engineer, or student, go through that scenario-based table again and again. I am more focused on it because it gives you an understanding to make new circuits based on these scenarios. All electrical circuits need a basic understanding to develop. The same scenario applies when you're dealing with reverse and forward operation with star configuration and then delta configuration. If you are making a similar control circuit in PLC, the difference is that in PLC, you don't need so much wiring, but you can make these interlocks in the logic, which saves a lot of time. If you need the PLC programming for this operation, just comment, and I'll try to produce a video on it to help you guys. Also, if you're confused at any point in this video, just comment, and I'll clear all your misunderstandings. I hope you found this video helpful and enjoyable. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with others to show your love and support. Your engagement keeps me motivated to bring more valuable content for you.